this video, I'll show you how to use any of our top 10 packages, from downloading them to installing them all the way through to testing and finally trading the EAs on live accounts. So stay with me until the end, because every step is important. The first thing you need to do after you download the compressed files is to unzip them. So right click over the file and I'll hit on extract all. You can select the folder where you want to store them and just click on extract. Right here I have the expert advisors for MetaTrader 4. I'll do the very same thing with the MT5 file. I'll click on extract all and I'll extract those as well. So right now I have all the expert advisors for MetaTrader 5. You will also receive the portfolio expert advisors, which are individual expert advisors, but they combine all of the 10 expert advisors into one expert advisor, but I'll get to that later in the video. Once you have the expert advisors ready, what you need to do is to open a demo account with any regulated broker that you prefer. At EA Trading Academy, we have listed a few brokers that we are using. They are all regulated, but that's a personal choice which broker you want to use. Once you select the broker, you need to open a demo account. So once you register for a demo account, you need to install the platform on your computer. I'll double click on the installation file, and from settings you can select where you want to install the platform. You can install more than one platform on your computer if you just change the destination. For example, you can add a number to the name of the installation folder, and this way you can install many platforms on your computer. Once it's installed, the platform will open automatically, and I'll click on file and I will hit on login to trade account. I'll copy paste the account number and the password which I have selected to use. The server is Black Bull Markets /demo in this example, and I'll click on OK. This will connect the account to the server of the broker, and a good indication that you're connected with the server of the broker is to see the bid and the ask prices or the quotes provided from the broker. So now I'll show you how to put the 10 expert advisors on MetaTrader. I will select the MT5 expert advisors, I'll copy them all, and I will paste them in file open data folder MQL5 experts. I will drop them in here, but this is the source code of the expert advisor. If I double click on it, you will see that I can see all of the code behind the robot, which means that we'll provide you with the source code. There is nothing hidden and you can see what is inside. If you're an experienced developer, you can modify or change anything you decide. If you are not, you need to compile it, and this will create the ready to use file. You need to do the very same thing for the rest, which I'll do quickly. Once I'm ready with all of the files, I can place them now on the charts. I'll go to expert advisors, right click, and I'll hit refresh. This will display the expert advisors down below in the navigator. And if you're using MetaTrader 4, you can just hit on refresh and this will compile the expert advisors automatically. So you don't need to compile them one by one. So now I will start placing them on the charts. I'll need only euro dollar charts, and all of them should be on M15 time frame. I can remove the grid with Control G, for example, or remove any of the indicators displayed. You don't need any of the indicators on the chart, but once you place the expert advisor on the chart, the indicators will display and you will see that in a second. First, I'll need to enable the algo trading, and then I'll just drag and drop the first expert advisor, and here are the inputs of the expert advisor. Let me just click on OK so you will see how the indicators are displayed over the charts, so we can follow along with the strategy that executes the trades. And there is some information about the expert, the stats, which you will see from the input. So now I'll go back to the expert, and I'll go to the properties, and I will explain all of these. The first one is the magic number, which is a unique number that helps us to track the performance of the expert advisors, which you will see at the end of the video. Then is the entry lot. It is up to you with how much you will be trading. It depends on your risk tolerance or the account size you will be using. By default, the EAs come with 0.1 lot. Then we have the stop loss and the take profit. This particular strategy uses the stochastic, the Bollinger Bands, and the envelopes. There are some entry protections and account protections. So if you want to limit the trades when there is volatility on the market, for example, you can set it to 30 points, which means that if the spread increases above 3 pips, it will not execute trades. You can also limit the maximum positions open. So if you're trading with 10 expert advisors, but you don't want to trade with all of them, you can just limit them to whatever number you decide. Then you have the maximum open lots. Again, you can limit to the amount of lots being opened. Then we have the account protections, which are very useful, especially if you use the EAS for prop firm challenges. The maximum daily loss is in currency. So if you start with $10,000, you can set the max daily loss to 500, and you won't risk more than 5% of the account. The minimum equity you can set at 9,000, or you can actually set it to 9,010 or $50, whatever amount you want your trading to stop at. If these protections are reached, the EA will activate them and it will close all the positions and it will remove all of the EAs from the charts. Then we have the maximum equity, which is useful also for prop firm challenges. Let's say you want to reach 11,000, you can just set it to $11,050, and once you reach to that level, again the expert advisor will close the trades and it will remove itself from the chart, so there will be no more trading. We have also news filter, which is very useful if you don't want to trade during the news. You can decide if you want to avoid just the high news, or you want to avoid the medium and the high news. Then you can decide how long you want to stop trading before the news and how long you want to wait after the news are released. And on the bottom we have the settings, where you can select between true and false. So if you keep it to true, it will display the indicators over the chart, but this is for MetaTrader 5 and not for MetaTrader 4, at least for the moment. The stats are regarding this information that you see on the chart, and you can decide if you want to see the position stats, the expert stats, and the account stats. And once you click on OK, all changes will be saved and displayed on the chart. And it's the very same thing you have to do for the other 9 expert advisors. So first I'll need to open new chart window. I'll switch to M15. I will drag and drop it over the chart. I will keep it to the default right now and I will click on OK. This will display the indicators and it will attach the expert on the chart. So I'll do the very same thing for the other 8 expert advisors. And here it is. I have the 10 expert advisors attached to 10 different charts. So once you set it, you don't need to do anything else, and it takes just a few minutes. However, the easier thing is to trade the portfolio expert advisor. So I'll just show it to you as well. I'll copy it, I'll go to file, open data folder, I'll put it together with the rest of the expert advisors, and I'll double click on it. You can also access the code of the portfolio expert advisor, but for now I'll just compile it, and I will also see it in the navigator. I'll open one more chart window and I'll just switch to M15 and double click on it. From the input, so you can see that we have the entry lot, but this is for each individual strategy inside of the portfolio expert advisor. You can change the base magic number, and here are the protections. If I click on OK, I will attach the Portfolio Expert Advisor on one chart, which means that all of the 10 strategies or the 10 robots will trade on one single chart. Now let me show you how to backtest the Expert Advisors on MetaTrader. On this account, I have the 10 Gold Expert Advisors and I'm testing them in a different account. So I use a VPS to keep testing all of the EAs, and for the beginners, a VPS is a virtual private server, which is a virtual machine, so it never gets disconnected, but obviously it is an extra cost. So in one of my VPSs, I have a few accounts where I'm testing the top 10 EAs, and in this one I have the gold EAs. So let me show you how to backtest the expert advisors. I'll right click on any of the EAs in the navigator and I'll hit on test. The strategy tester will open below, and I have the expert I'll be testing, the symbol, the time frame, and I can select if I want to test it for the entire history that the broker provides, or for the last 1 month, last 1 year, or I can select a custom period. Let's stick to entire history, as modeling out suggested to use open prices only, because the strategies behind the robots work at the opening of the bar. I'll click on that modeling option. Deposit is $10,000, leverage 1 to 100, so it depends on the account type you have, and then I'll click on start. The backtest is usually very quick, and if I show you the backtest outcome, we can see the results. For example, it made a total net profit of $5,686. We can see the gross profit, the gross loss, and a lot more information that MetaTrader offers when we are backtesting expert advisors. Obviously, the interesting thing to look at is the graph. So we can see that this account started at $10,000, it went on a profit, then there was a decline in 2020, and now it is on profit. All in all, it made about $5,000 and something. Then if I want to test any of the other expert advisors, I can simply select the arrow for the drop down menu, and I'll select it, I'll hit on start, and I will see the graph for this expert advisor. Now remember that we really don't aim to create expert advisors with perfect backtests, because we do not depend fully on the backtest. We test the expert advisors on demo accounts and we select which ones to put on live accounts. We want to see the expert advisors that are currently profiting. And most vendors on the MQL5 marketplace are selling EAs with perfect backtest lines because this just sells better. But me as a trader, I want to have strategies behind the expert advisor. So logical trading strategies make much more sense to me rather than the perfect backtest, which usually results in over optimization, and such EAs with perfect backtest line usually fail in a live environment. So now let me show you how I'm testing the EAs, and I will switch to the other MetaTrader platform where I have the Euro dollar, the gold expert advisors, and the Bitcoin expert advisors. But in this demo account, I have only the portfolio expert advisors. So right in here, I have the 10 expert advisors for Euro dollar, the 10 gold expert advisors, and the 10 Bitcoin expert advisors. And I have connected this account with my FX book, which is a statistical website, and we can see which of the expert advisors are profiting at the time whenever you are testing the robots. And usually I look at the last 1 week, and I waited for a losing week to show you that if the account is dropping, there will be EAs that will be profiting inside. And I have traded just these 3 expert advisors on a live account with DarwinX, and you can see that for the very same period of time, the account actually had a very good result. Now, if this sounds complicated, let me explain it to you. In a demo account, I have placed the portfolio expert advisor on one chart, and this one has a magic number starting with 100. And this way I know that this expert advisor and the second one are from the euro dollar pack. The expert advisor for the gold starts with 200. And this way I know that the third expert advisor is from the gold. And here is the Darwin X account. Here I have decided to trade the euro dollar and the gold. And if I right click on the expert advisor and I hit on modify, from the code I can easily see which strategies are being used. By default they are all enabled, but once I start tracking the results on the demo account, I see which ones are the most profitable. And at this time, the one ending on 06 and the one ending on 08 were the most profitable. So what I would usually do is I would remove the two forward slashes, and this makes the two expert advisors active. Once I hit on compile, only these two expert advisors will be active in the portfolio expert advisor. So in the testing account, I trade all of them, and you will see that there are a lot of trades being open and closed. All of the 30 EAs are active and are opening and closing trades. So then I connect this account to my FX book and I track the performance for the last 1 week. From there I can see which expert advisors are most profitable, and I decided to put the top three in my Darwin X Live account. So I have the euro and the gold charts with the portfolio expert advisors, but one more time, I keep active just the expert advisors that are profitable at the current moment whenever I'm trading the expert advisors. And that's the easiest solution. The other option is to put the 10 different expert advisors on 10 different charts, just as I showed in the video, and you can still connect them to my FX book or FX Blue and put on the live account only the top performers that are profiting the most. But I prefer to do it with the portfolio expert advisor just because it's easier, and if you are trading three of the top 10 packages, you just need three charts and not 30 charts on your MetaTrader platform. So one more time, I have placed the portfolio expert advisor for euro dollar, for gold and for Bitcoin, and I have decided to trade in my live account only the euro dollar and the gold, and to use only the strategies that are profiting at the current moment. And I showed you the example of this week from the 27th of November until 1st of December. Overall, the account balance was dropping, but there were strategies that were profitable at this time. And I used the three most profitable strategies in my live account, and you can see that exactly for that period it brought the account on a profit. But of course it's a personal choice if you want to use all of them or only the top performance. You can only use the best EA from the pack, or the top 3, the top 5, the top 10. It's up to you, and it is up to you how many packs of EAs you will combine in order to find the best expert advisors to trade on your live accounts. However, I would suggest you first to open a second demo account so you can simulate live trading, and you can keep testing all the EAs in one account and in another demo account to place only the top performers. This way you will get used to the process, and by tracking the results you will find how you feel comfortable trading the expert advisors. I really thank you for watching the video until the end, and I wish you safe trading.